cooking, everyone.
You're never going to guess what I have right here. I have a 2¾-pound tomahawk steak. Angus, USDA choice. I bought this for $27, so very happy with this. It's been sitting here for a little while, about 2 hours, with black Himalayan sea salt on it, all around it. Rock salt. And it's because beef loves salt. And this is just being soaked into the meat. I'm going to take this off, and I'm going to season it with just three simple ingredients besides... My binder purposely is going to be virgin olive oil, garlic. So stay with me, and we're going to put this together. All right. You see this with this nice black salt on it? That's rock salt. I'm taking it off. Oh, look at that. See how that's sweated out like that? Oh, that's very nice. Nice. I've also got some on the fat. Yes, nice looking sweat. Oh, this is beautiful. 4 inches thick. I think it might even be a little bit more than 4 inches thick. I want to know how many of you are betting that I can't get this properly done as thick as it is. Comment down below. I've scored this fat. See that? I've just made slices in it, and then came across too. And that's going to help render this fat into this flavorful, juicy, juicy, delicious meat. Oh, look at that. All right, I'm going to put this away. Okay, so what I'm going to do is we're going to use this squeezed garlic. And it's made with extra virgin olive oil. Okay. That's actually for both sides, guys. So, oh yeah, look at this. We're going to rub it all over this. Okay, now we'll get this rubbed onto this side. Maybe even add just a little bit more of it, just to make sure I've got both sides fairly. Ooh, it's so nice looking. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and hit that. Give all this a good loving. Okay, set that down. And next thing we're going to go with, now I'm taking some regular, not regular, it's also rock salt. It's pink and black Himalayan mixed. Don't be afraid to give your beef some salt, because beef loves it. And you'll love it too. Yes, indeed. Now I'm going to put the lid on this real quick so that I can actually get some in the well, so I can get this back corner. Okay. Alrighty. I'm going to sprinkle that on there. Look at that. Oh yeah. All the way up into that fat too. Go ahead and get it into that fat. Very nice. Now, I need to flip this bad boy over, and let's do this again. Look at that. Mm-hmm. And there's probably going to be still a couple pieces of that rock salt that's on there. That's fine. That should do it real nice. Montreal steak seasoning, okay? It is, I highly recommend it. I will say this, though, the only reason why I'm using this is because I'm out of the Chicago style. I think that the Chicago style is really good too. Another thing, beef loves pepper, so don't be afraid to put this stuff on there, including your fat. Look at that. Ooh, oh yeah. So pretty. Oh yeah, that's pretty. Sucking that in. Mm-hmm. Let's get this. Oh yes. All right. Oh yes. Oh. Now, y'all know me well enough by now to know that this instant coffee of any brand is a wonderful thing on almost all meats, but especially beef. So I'm gonna spread that in there. I know it looks like a lot, but it's really not. This will really add a lot of good flavor, lock a lot of those flavors in. Any brand is good. And if you ever watch the Bearded Butchers, they actually have their own rubs that have this in it. Okay, let's get some on this fat here. Yes, indeed, that's some pretty meat. Pretty meat. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have to wash up a lot of stuff now. So what I'm gonna do here is we're gonna let this sit just for a little while. You know how I like to have it sweating. You stay tuned. We're going to bring you right back as soon as this is ready. Pow. It's dark again, so this is ready to go. Put this on this nice hot grill. Oh, you hear that, children? Boy, oh yeah. Gotta get that nice mesquite flavor on it. Here, put the lid on it nice and pretty. I love this. This time of year, this colder outside and everything like that, I love this. We tend to barbecue later on the weekends. We just do. I don't know why.
Well, it's only like 6:30. It's not even late.
I like the way it feels out here, all that stuff. So stick with us. We're going to be back. Okay, this thing, I have a surprise to finish this. So don't fast forward, and you know who you are. No fast forwarding. This is going to be great, okay? I Let's wrap this beautiful piece of meat in this bacon. Mmm, that's a wonderful smell. Oh. And this is the surprise I was talking about. Wrap big old tomahawk in some good regular cut bacon. We're going to let this rest for a couple minutes with this raw bacon on it before I put it back on the grill, because I want the grill to get really hot. I just added more coals for more heat. Oh, yeah. What do you think, honey?
It smells delicious. I want to have some right now.
I know. It really does smell good. I think that I will add, just for the front of this beautiful steak, let's see if I can do this without messing it up. Just lift this beautiful, beautiful piece of meat. Let's get that wrapped right there. Right. Yes.
That's really nice looking. I can't wait to have some of that.
Now you can smell already that the bacon's kind of...
Yeah, I smell it.
...getting warm against this hot steak. So we'll let this sit here like this. One more right here to catch this very last little bit of opening. Oh yeah. Okay. Don't wanna mess it up. I don't wanna. Here we go. I wanna try, hopefully this will hold its shape. Okay, I just have a little bit in the front here. I figure we might as well use all the bacon.
Might as well.
Okay. And then this will wrap.
Perfect.
That here.
Beautiful.
All I want to do is let this bacon rest and for a minute while this is hot. And what I want to do is just put some just only coarse ground black pepper on this. It's not going to need any salt. I think that this will add a great flavor to this bacon.
It smells really good.
I don't even want to tempt the other side. I think we'll just keep it like this. We're going to give it about 10 minutes. It's going to go back on that hot grill. So stay tuned. There's wonderful things. We're going to have some carrots and some macaroni and cheese with this. Just a simple. I love the simple sides. I really do. I think that the steak goes good with macaroni and cheese. So
sometimes we just like the mac and cheese.
Yeah, it's just that good old box
Kraft macaroni
and cheese, man. So,
That smells really good.
You get a nice crispness there, and we're just going to keep letting it crisp up. What I did here, even though we were using mesquite, coals is I put a little good old Mount St. Helens cherry wood on there, and we're going to get that bacon a little bit of a cherry flavor over the top. Beef loves cherry. Bacon loves cherry. So just, oh gosh, the smell is driving me nuts. So anyway, we're going to let this, patiently let this just, I want this to be crisp on the outside. So it's beautiful.
Looks delicious.
I'm going to put this lid back on it so it can just crisp up. Oh, yeah. Stick with me, folks. It is done. Now I'm going to cut. Check out the bacon. Go ahead and just... Oh, my goodness. Oh, yeah. Cuts right through. Just make sure. Look at that. Oh, look at the pink. It's perfect. The pink is perfect. Look at this meat. Mmm. That's the way her and I like it.
That's delicious.
Wow. Okay.
Mmm. Lots of flavor.
Now that fat rendered just like I hoped it would.
Yeah.
And you notice that salt really...
It's fabulous.
Gosh. We let this rest for 15 minutes after I pulled it off the grill. So I'm going to go one more slice this way. And then look at that meat.
Juicy and beautiful.
Very juicy. Oh my gosh. I have to try this. The
flavor is fabulous.
Let me get your piece off the... Oh. This is from the middle. Oh, man. This... The, oh, geez. Those flavors really got sucked into this meat. And you can taste that all the way into the middle. And look at how juicy that is. That's just juice. Oh, man. Now, I have another one of these that I'm going to cook in the near future. Give me some ideas if you're interested in helping me out. Give me some ideas. How should I make the next one of these? The next one of these is bigger than this. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting me. God bless, and have a great evening. It's the thing that it does in your mouth. It's just unbelievable. This is really good. It's really, really good.